Hi, I'm Joe Alcon. I'm a board-certified plastic surgeon located in central New Jersey. I've been in practice since 2005, and my practice focuses exclusively on elective or cosmetic breast and body surgery. Today, I thought I'd spend a couple minutes talking to you about the initial consultation during plastic surgery. A lot of patients come in, they're nervous, they're anxious, they're excited, they're not really sure what to expect, so I thought it might be a little helpful to really explain to you what typically occurs during initial consultation to help better prepare you for it. The consultation is really a time for you to learn about the surgical options and what to expect. But it's also a time for your surgeon to learn quite a bit about you. The initial consultation is a time for you to really learn about the surgery you're considering and to really help better prepare you for it. What happens during the initial consultation? The first thing we talk about is any medical history you might have. Sometimes people worry that just because they might have a medical condition that they may not be able to have plastic surgery. I have many patients who safely undergo plastic surgery who have some sort of prior medical condition. Some patients have thyroid conditions, high blood pressure, asthma, etc. It really depends on the severity of it and how well controlled it is. Next, let's talk about what surgeries have you had. Have you had hernia surgery, gallbladder surgery, appendix, C-section, whatever the case may be? Just because you've had prior surgery doesn't necessarily mean you cannot have particular plastic surgery. It just better helps us prepare for your upcoming surgery. Do you smoke? Smoking is a big topic that we discussed during the consultation. A lot of times patients don't want to talk about it, but it's well known that smoking can really increase your risk of difficulty healing and complications. So during the consultation, we really review any smoking or other types of substance history, and just for how long you need to be completely smoke-free or substance-free in planning for your surgery for your best, safest outcome. Do you take any medications? And I don't just mean prescription medications. Sometimes people forget to mention they might be on herbal medicines, vitamins, supplements, whatever the case may be. Some of them might be great for you, but some of them sometimes have to be stopped before surgery because they might increase your risk of a complication. Do you have kids? Are you planning on having children soon? Are you done having children? All this can help determine whether the timing is right for you and upcoming surgery. Then let's talk about the surgery itself. How is the surgery performed? Where is the surgery performed? Is it a hospital, a surgery center, someone's office? Will you be awake or will you be asleep? Who's providing the anesthesia? Is there an anesthesia doctor there or someone else suited for this? And what about afterwards? Will you have drains? Will you not have drains? What even are drains? Do you have to wear special garments? Are there certain supplies you might need? Can you drive after surgery? Can you do lifting or exercise or pick up small kids? Will you need someone to help you or stay with you after surgery? These are all things that we have to discuss. When can you shower? Everybody wants to take a warm shower. When's it safe to do so? Will you need pain medicine or other medications after surgery? All this comes down to part of the initial consultation to help you better prepare for upcoming surgery. We often discuss, are there other options available to you? And oftentimes, you might have come in wanting surgery A, but there might be another option that's better suited for you based on your goals, your history, etc. And we discuss that during the initial consultation. All of this is part of the initial consultation. I often recommend that patients write down a list of questions or things that they might be concerned about. So you're there, there's a lot of information you're taking in, and sometimes you might forget to ask something. So it's great if you have a list just to make sure all of your questions are answered. Lastly, I always tell patients, you can always call. It's completely normal to think of stuff after you go. Make that same list, call us, and we'll be happy to go over it with you. I'm Joe Alcon. Thanks, and we'll see you soon.